Minasan, konnichiwa. Hello everybody. We are coming to the lesson 8. And it is the last lesson for the midterm examination. So in this chapter, I would like to focus on the grammar. And we are going to learn two new words that is showing the existence of something. For example, there's a book on the table, or there are students in the classroom, or there is a bookstore in the department store. So these two words is showing the existence of something at some place. Now the two verbs I was talking about is arimasu and imasu. For arimasu is using with things, and imasu using with people and animals. So besides people and animals, everything else we use arimasu. The meaning of a sentence is like there is something at some place. So if we translate this into Thai, Thai people will say mi arai yu ti nai. So the verb arimasu and imasu showing the existence of something at some place. Imasu using with people and animals, and arimasu using with other things in the world. Now let's see some example. For example, I say there is a book on the table. There is a book, so the book is a thing, right? So if you need to choose between arimasu and imasu, which one you're going to choose? The answer is arimasu, right? There are students in the classroom. Students are people, are human. So if you have to choose between arimasu and imasu, which one are you going to choose? So we will choose imasu, right? Imasu. There is an onsen at Nikko. I hope you know the word onsen. It's a very popular place nowadays. Onsen is a public bath in Japan. Nikko is the name of a town in Japan. At Nikko, there are lots of temples and shrines and many cultural places for you to visit. So if you're going to Nikko, you will see a lot of trees, a lot of mountains, and of course there is also a public bath which is called onsen. There's an onsen at Nikko. Onsen is the things, right? So onsen, we use the verb arimasu. There is a bookshop on the second floor of the department store. There is a bookshop, so the bookshop we will use arimasu. Now we move on to the grammar. For these arimasu and imasu, we use the grammar pattern as place, ni, thing, or people, ga, arimasu. And if it's a people, it becomes imasu. Place, ni, thing, ga, arimasu. Place, ni, people or person ga imasu. So you will see that when there is something, we use ga. And at some place, we use ni. We use ni to point out the place, and we use ga to point out the thing or the person. And if it's a person, then you change arimasu to imasu. I would like to explain this concept again in Thai. Arimasu แล้วก็ imus เป็น verb ในภาษาไทยแปลว่ามีนะครับมีอะไรอยู่ที่ไหนมีอะไรสิ่งของหรือคนใช้ particle ga มีอยู่ที่ไหนสถานที่ใช้ particle นิเพราะว่านิจะชี้จุดนะครับจุดของเวลาจุดของสถานที่นะครับเป็นที่ที่เราระบุไปว่ามีสิ่งของหรือคนอยู่ที่นี่เพราะฉะนั้นนักศึกษาต้องจำว่ามีอะไรหรือมีใครใช้ก็มีอยู่ที่ไหนใช้นิโอเค now back into English place นิสิ่งกับอาริมัส there'sNot many options for you, but to memorize this place ni tinga arimas. All right. So let's move on to another example. Let's look at the example together. Teburu no ue ni. Ue means on. Teburu, table. Teburu no ue ni. On the table. Hon ga arimasu. There is a book. Basu no naka ni. Basu means the bus.Naka mean inside. Basu no naka ni inside of the bus. Gakusei ga imasu. There is or there are students. So why we use imasu here? Because gakusei is people, right? So we use imasu instead of arimasu. Now for this chapter,If you would like to make it as a question, there can be four types of question here. The first one is doko ni arimasu ka? Do you remember the word doko means where, right? And if you ask the things that made from where, that would be doko no, right? Now, doko niIs pointing out the place. Doko ni arimasu ka? Where is it? Where is it? You can say doko ni arimasu ka, or you can say it shortly as doko desu ka? Doko desu ka? Because desu represent is mr, right? So you can whether say doko ni arimasu ka or doko desu ka. Now, if it is people.You can say doko ni imasu ka? Doko ni imasu ka? Now we're looking for the place. We would like to point out the place. So we ask these kind of questions. Doko ni arimasu ka? Doko ni imasu ka? If you want to ask for the thing, what is there? What is there? For the thing, we ask nani ga arimasu ka?Nani ga arimasu ka? What is there? Dare ga imasu ka? Dare ga imasu ka? Who is there? Dare represent people, so we use imasu. So can you reveal this by yourself? What does it mean, doko ni arimasu ka? Where is it? Doko ni imasu ka? Where is that person, right?Nani ga arimasu ka? What is there? Dare ga imasu ka? Who is there? For Japanese people, there are special expression whichwill come with the form of a certain grammar. You need to memorize the phrase like this. There are two of them for this chapter. Number one is nani mo arimasen. Nani mo arimasen. Whatever it is not there. So what does it mean? Nani mo arimasen. It means there is nothing there. ถ้าเราแปลเป็นไทยนะครับแปลตรงๆก็จะได้ว่าอะไรอะไรก็ไม่มีนั่นหมายความว่าไม่มีอะไรอยู่ที่นั่นนั่นเองนะครับ Nothing is there. Now another one, dare mo imasen. Whoever is also not there. So the meaning is there's nobody there. This one, there's nothing there. This one, there's nobody is there. ใครๆก็ไม่อยู่ก็คือไม่มีใครเลยนะครับ For example, I can say table no ue ni on the table nani mo arimasen. There's nothing on the table. Basu no naka ni in the bus dare mo imasen. There's nobody. All right. The grammar for this chapter is new to you, but it's not difficult. It's not difficult. If you can memorize the pattern, place ni tinga arimas. And if it is a people, then you change arimas to imas. So that's it. All right. So we move on to the opening dialogue.The target dialogue for lesson 8 is about going to Nikko. As I say, Nikko is the name of the place where people love to travel because there are lots of temples and shrines and the old heritage of Japan. So let's look at the conversation together.The conversation is about Mr. Kato and Mr. Chan is talking about Nikko. Mr. Kato said, Doyobi ni on, Doyobi on Saturday, Kasoku to Nikko ni ikimasu. I will go to Nikko with family, Kasoku, family, on Saturday.Now, I hope you still remember the grammar from last chapter. If you're going to some place, you use particle ni to point out the destination. If you're going with somebody, you use particle to. And then the time, specific time, you use particle ni. So the meaning is I will go to Nikko with family on Saturday. So desu ka?ニコに何がありますか?ニコに何がありますか? Place に thing があります。What is there at ニコ? In ニコ, what is it there? What is there in ニコ? ニコに何がありますか? 大きいお寺やโอเค big โอเทรา temple จินจาก็อาริมัส there's a big temples and shrines จินจา is shrines so what's the difference between temple and shrines in the Japanese culture the temple is built to worshipThe God. Jinja is built to worship some of the sacred spirits. For example, if somebody who was human like us and did something very good in the past or have some magical power, when they died, people built jinja, people built the shrine to respect, to worship them. So temples are for gods, and jinja are for other form of magical powers, like people who died and become something special, become angels, something like that. So there's a big temples and shrine at Nikko. Onsen mo arimasu. There also an onsen. Onsen te nan desu ka? Onsen te is mean we talking about onsen. We can say onsen wa nan desu ka? What is onsen? So he's pointing out the picture in the brochure and say Nihon no supa desu yo. Nihon no supa desu yo. It's a spa. It's a spa of Japan. It's a spa of Japan. Ii desu ne. That's good. That's good. So they conclude the sentence as Kato-san wa doyoubi ni kasoku to Nikko ni ikimasu. Mr. Kato is going to Nikko with family on Saturday. Nikko ni ooki o tera ya jinja ga arimasu. At Nikko, there are shrines and temples. Now, we see there is a new particle, ya. Ya. The meaning of ya is like to, it means and. There's a temples and the shrines. But ya, like you give some examples and say, there's a temple and shrines and something else, and etc. Something like that. So by saying ya, it's like you just show some examples and there's also something else at Nikko. I'll read for you from the beginning again. Are you ready? 土曜日に家族とニコに来ます。 On Saturday, I will go to Nikko with my family. そうですか。ニコに何がありますか? Ah, okay. So what is there at Nikko? 大きいお寺や神社があります。温泉もあります。 There's the shrines and temples at Nikko. And there's also, an onsen. Onsen te nan desu ka? What is onsen, by the way? Kore desu, this one. Nihon no supa desu yo. It's the Japanese spa. Ii desu ne. Wow, that's good. So for this chapter, I will focus only on the target dialogue and the grammar pattern that I'm giving you at the beginning of the video clip. So please study just that for the midterm examination. And good luck to all of you. See you soon. 皆さん、さようなら。